Nostalgia is the big thing these days, and with school days winding down for this year, we thought it might be a great time to send Mike Randall back to his old high school to find out how things have changed since he graduated. Here now is the first in Mike's three-part series.
The old place looks pretty much the same, sort of. It's the students that seem to have changed. The way they look.
Being different is what's cool.
The way they talk.
Roy is like somebody who doesn't fit in at all.
The way they think.
Well, it's just the new generation. People are, men are becoming more independent.
It's kind of hard to believe that 15 years have passed since Joy to the World was the number one song. Like a lot of kids, I couldn't wait to get out of high school. For that reason, this return visit to Kenmore West is a mixture of nervous anticipation, fond memories, and a stark realization that it's been 15 years since I was that teenager preoccupied with girls, getting into college, and growing facial hair.
By the time I was actually able to grow sideburns, they were out of style. But aside from that, I look exactly the same. Sort of, don't I?
Jerry Trent and Annette Herr, faculty advisors to the class of 1971, seem to think that 15 years haven't changed what's cool in school.
Gee, I really don't think that much has changed. I think kids are kids, no matter when.
I think they're dressing differently now. You don't have everyone looking exactly like everyone else.
One place to find out what's happening in the teen world is in the heart of every high school, the cafeteria. Seems to be the same social hotspot it always was. Things haven't changed a bit. Wait a minute. You're kidding me. There's a Coke machine in the cafeteria? What else are these kids eating?
Oh, and potato chips.
Donuts and Twinkies and Susie Q's and stuff.
What's cool in the cafeteria these days is junk food.
They tell us that the good food will kill us, and they tell us that the bad food will kill us, so who cares? Let's have good, the junk food tastes better.
Tomorrow night, we'll take a look at the latest in fads and fashion to find out what's really cool in school. Compared to 1971, almost anything would be an improvement. This is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.
Mike got better with age, didn't he?
Yeah, he sure did. He grew a mustache anyway. Finally, you'll recall that last night, when our man Mike Randall revisited his high school alma mater, he got a few surprises. Well, tonight, Mike is still doing double takes.
The sights.
I wear what I want to wear because I feel comfortable in it.
And the sounds.
I don't consider myself punk.
Of high school 1986. They're a sharp reminder of just how much things have changed at Kenmore West High School since I graduated in 1971.
Everyone wants to be different, stand out a little way, or do something that's different. And I think 15 years ago, the thing was, they said they would be themselves, but everyone dressed alike, looked alike, acted alike.
As part of the class of 1971, I have to agree, we all looked like we came out of the same cookie cutter.
You know, it's hard to believe we actually dressed like that in 1971. Nice jacket.
Thanks, man.
These days, you'll find a little more variety around here.
If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits? Putting on the Ritz.
It's practically impossible to figure out what's cool in school when it comes to fashion these days. What's cool for one kid.
I don't like rules of society and stuff like that, sort of, but so I like to be different.
Isn't necessarily cool for another.
Well, actually, I've been listening to Marines, and they just say, why don't you shave your head? So I shave my head.
This is called waking up in the morning and going in your closet and picking anything that doesn't match and putting it on.
Well, usually people are just pinning their pants down at the ankles, and I just like them up on my coat.
Dressed up like a million-dollar trooper.
People don't have to look all the same. People can be themselves. They can be different if they want to.
There you have it. What's cool in school in the 1980s is everything. Well, almost everything.
Homework's kind of out. And
Homework's always been out.
Homework's always out, yeah.
Tomorrow night, visit a class where they're teaching guys the ancient art of washing dishes. This is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.
Well, as Bob Dylan said, the times, they are a-changing. I'm going to bring that, Finally, Back to the Future, Mike Randall style, as Mike wraps up his series on what's cool in school.
Returning to my high school 15 years later is not the culture shock I thought it would be. The kids still talk pretty much the same.
Is cool cool?
Is cool cool? Yeah, it's cool.
The classes and even many of the teachers are the same. Peter Pavlakis has been teaching chemistry at Kenmore West for 29 years.
Because otherwise you'll stop at some incomplete part.
Things are a lot looser, and I think it's for the better. You know how the pendulum keeps swinging back and forth, and hopefully it stays in the middle longer than at any extreme.
What are the conditions for the return of the security deposit?
One class that seems to be pretty cool in school didn't even exist 15 years ago. It's a class where you'll find guys washing dishes.
I might have to do it someday. I figured it'd be good to learn how to do it.
These guys are learning how to cook and sew, too.
Men are becoming more independent and, you know, living on their own. And, you know, those things are necessary.
The course is called Independent Living, and the instructor, Linda Ulrich Hagner, is teaching these young men and women a lot more than basic housekeeping.
People need people skills. The kids are just more receptive to dual roles, and they are learned skills. Mm. It's just because my father didn't do dishes doesn't mean I can't get my hands in a dishpan.
Yeah, I'm calling about the apartment you have in the paper for rent.
Well, as luck would have it, the apartment became available 2 days ago.
By role-playing, the students are learning valuable real-life skills like how to rent an apartment.
Is there a security deposit on that?
You tell them if they're going up the driveway with, like, two cases of beer and a set of drums, somebody's going to say, thanks, but no thanks, we already have it rented.
Since 1971, things in high school have changed a little, a lot, and not at all. One thing's for sure, time has been kind to Kenmore West and me. It'll be interesting to find out how we weather the next 15 years. Until the year 2001, this is Mike Randall at Kenmore West for Eyewitness News.
Well, now that we know what Mike is going to look like in 15 years, here, as promised, are high school pictures of Don and me. Stop laughing.